I am Abayomi Jolayemi. I'll be showing you Pascal's triangle, how we can use Pascal's triangle to expand algebraic expression, to expand algebraic expression. Pascal's triangle is formed in mathematics, and it is named after French mathematician called Blaise Pascal. In this Pascal's triangle, I'll be showing you its triangle in recess, and also how we can use it to expand algebraic expression. Consider the expression of each of the following: x plus y all raised to 0, x plus y all raised to 1, x plus y raised to 2, x plus y raised to 3, x plus y raised to 4. Let me start with x plus y raised to 0. If we expand this, we are getting 1. We are getting 1. Then the next one, which is x plus y raised to 1, we are getting 1x plus 1y. The next one, which is x plus y raised to 2, we are getting 1x raised to 2 plus 2xy plus 1y raised to 2. The next one, which is x plus y raised to 3, we will get 1x raised to 3 plus 3x raised to 2y plus 3xy raised to 2 plus 1y raised to 3. Then x plus y raised to 4 will give us 1x raised to 4 plus 4x raised to 3y plus 6x raised to 2y raised to 2 plus 4xy raised to 3 plus 1y raised to 4. Now, the coefficients of this can be displayed in an array. That means coefficients of x and y can be displayed in an array as 1, which is the coefficient of the first algebraic expression, 1, 1, which is coefficient of the second, 1, 2, 1, which is the coefficient of this third one. Then we have 1, 3, 3, 1, which is the coefficient of this, and the last one, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1, which is the coefficient of x plus y raised to power 4. The array of the coefficients displayed is called Pascal's triangle. Pascal's triangle. That means this array of the coefficients of the x and y is called Pascal's triangle. You can see they are in form of triangle. I will be explaining some features attached to this Pascal's triangle. Features. Pascal triangle. One is each line of the coefficients is symmetrical. That means each line of the coefficients is symmetrical. Example, the coefficient of the first expression is 1. It is symmetrical to the coefficient of the second expression. You can see it is symmetrical. And this is symmetrical to the coefficient of the third. Why this, they are symmetrical to the coefficient of the fourth. They are symmetrical. And this is symmetrical to the coefficient of x plus y raised to power 4. They are symmetrical in nature. Then 2 says each line of coefficients can be obtained from the line of coefficients immediately preceding it. That means each line of coefficients can be obtained from the line of coefficient preceding it. You can see, since this is the coefficient of the first expression, we still have 1, 1 to be the coefficient of the second expression. But the coefficient of the third one can simply be obtained also from the coefficient of the one preceding it. You can see, the coefficient of the first one is 1. The second one will be 1 plus 1. That coefficient preceding it, add them together to get the next one. Then just because there is no any one to be added with this one, then the last will be 1. So also this one, if we are to get the coefficient of this one, since 1 starts the coefficient of the preceding, 1 will start this also. For you to get the coefficient of the second expansion, it becomes 1 plus 2 to give us 3. Then 2 plus 1 to give us 3. Then since there is no any one to be added, it will be 1. Also, this last one, starting with 1, 1 plus 3, 4, 3 plus 3, 6, 3 plus 1, 4. And since there's no any other one, it becomes 1. Therefore, each line of the coefficients can be obtained from the line of coefficients immediately preceding it. 3 says, as the expansion increases, the power of s drops, y the power of y increases. You can see, let me use this last one as an example. Now, the power of s is raised to power 4 because the power of the expansion is 4. And as you are increasing the expansion, the power of s will be dropping and power of s will be increasing. Don't forget, anything raised to power 0 is 1. Therefore, even if you put y raised to 0 here, it will be 1. So 1 times s raised to 4 is still s raised to 4. But here, since s drops, it becomes s raised to 3, then y will come. It drops again, s raised to 2, y will increase. It drops again, s raised to 1, y increases, until when s will be raised to 0, and s raised to 0 is 1, and we will be having only y raised to 4. So, therefore, I said the third feature of the Pascal triangle says, as the expansion increases, the power of S decreases and Y increases. That means the power of S decreases while the power of Y increases. These are the three features we have to consider when we are using Pascal triangle to expand algebraic expression. While we are using Pascal triangle to expand algebraic expression. till I see you again on this my platform, I am Abayomi Jola Yemi. I say you remain blessed.